everybody. Something new we're going to try here. We're going to try an Assassin's Creed podcast. I'm here with my buddy Aaron. Go ahead and introduce yourself.
Hi.
All right, so yeah, we're going to be talking a little bit about Assassin's Creed, just the brand new news that came out with it possibly being pushed back to 2017 in Egypt. We're going to talk about, you know, our favorite games, and we're going to ask each other 5 questions. And then we're going to see what type of character we fit best near the end. So while we're doing that, we're playing a little bit of Assassin's Creed Unity. We're doing a heist mission. And we're going to probably screw this up epically. So we'll see where we go. So just to start off with a bit of news, we both read about this and saw a couple videos about Assassin's Creed being no longer in 2016. Now, this is all rumor and speculation. Being pushed back to 2016, or being pushed back to 2017, excuse me, and it being possibly set in Egypt. So, Aaron, what's your take on this?
Well, definitely a new setting for Assassin's Creed.
Well, that's every year.
As we all know from playing Assassin's Creed in the past, we've always had, like, these big open cities where we can climb rooftops and do whatever we want. And, but I don't know much about Egypt, so I'm actually interested to find out for the historical part as well. So.
Okay. Yeah, definitely. Egypt, in other rumors, suggest that, I mean, if they're going to take on Egypt, right, you're thinking it's going to be going really, really far back, like past, you know, Altair setting. So, I mean, with an Assassin's Creed, this could actually set up the foundation of what the Assassins even are. Like, you always thought the Assassins were set up by, in Mos Yaf, in, you know, Assassin's Creed 1 with Altair, but, you know, what do you think about it, you know, starting with a brand new character?
Well, again, it would be interesting because the start of it all was Altair and the Creed itself.
Right, right, right. The three tenets that they've no longer mentioned in any Assassin's Creed game thus far. It seems like that is no longer the case. Jacob in Assassin's Creed Syndicate, when it's like, you know, never compromise the Brotherhood. We kill in plain sight. Or no, we kill like in the shadows or something like that. And he's like mass murdering people with his very own gang, so that kind of contradicts the Creed itself. But I think it's beyond the Creed, and I think it's now the Templar War.
Yes.
And I got something to say about that. I got a bone to pick with these recent installments. After Assassin's Creed 3, as we all know, It's been like, what, 3 years? So I'm just going to say it for people who haven't seen it. Desmond is dead. That's no news to us. After they killed off Desmond, I don't think the stories have been as strong as they are, or as they should be, at least.
Especially for the modern day.
Yeah, the modern day, it being basically taken out in Unity and in Syndicate as well. I mean, at least Assassin's Creed 4 tried. With, like, you moving around. Oh, crap. I got spotted. Did you get spotted?
Yes. I want to find poison in one of them.
Yeah, that's probably a good idea. But Egypt, that's crazy though.
Yes, Egypt is crazy because, like I said, I don't know much about Egypt. But
neither do I. But I mean, besides like pharaohs, fucking hieroglyphics, which
mummies, pyramids, that's about
yeah,
it.
I think Egypt is one of the best places to go, even though I've always wanted to go to Japan. Like feudal Japan, that's what I think every Assassin's Creed fan wants, but no one's getting. And I think why it would be good for the story is, think about it, hieroglyphics, pharaohs, that all deals with like pieces of Eden. I think that would work perfectly, don't you think?
Yes, I do believe. Oh, crap.
Yeah, Egypt.
Man, I forgot how hard the stealth was in this game. Like, you gotta be a true assassin in order to get past some of these guards.
Yeah, that's one of the. That's what I like about Assassin's Creed Unity, because even though they get a lot of shit for the glitches and whatnot, I think they nailed a lot of things right with this game. One, the co-op, as we're obviously
Co-op.
playing. Yeah, I mean we're playing that together right now. And the stealth, they tried to make that a priority. Like that's one of their like key pillars is stealth. And when you're Connor or Jacob, you know, right in the middle of plain sight, you know, just killing people right in plain sight, that doesn't really fit what an assassin is. And you kind of wonder, oh, how come these people who are mass murdering people not in the history books? You know what I mean? Even though I know it's a game, it's kind of like there's a lot of flaws in what their perception of reality is in the animus. But at least Unity tried that.
Well, and Unity, they actually answered my question because I've been waiting for a co-op Assassin's Creed ever since they first came out with it. I mean,
Yeah, I remember
when the
us.
Brotherhood first came out with the multiplayer, I was excited, but when I found out it wasn't what I was thinking,
Yeah.
then I was like, oh.
Definitely, definitely. Co-op is something I always wanted to, and getting to play that in Unity, one of the best looking games on the PS4, I think, still. Because this is a killer looking game.
And for how much stuff it does at once. I mean, look at this. We got people walking around, and like, it's these guards always stand at post, and these birds over here just flopping around. I mean, that honestly impresses me. But for like a console game.
Yeah, it definitely has its flaws, you know, obviously with glitches and whatnot. But that doesn't, for me, that doesn't take a whole lot away from the game. Every game has that now. But that's what everyone seems to be talking about with Assassin's Creed Unity. And that is actually the key reason why Assassin's Creed Empire is what it's supposedly called, is taking a break in 2016. You know, they said Unity was the reason why, because it obviously had a lot of bugs. So they wanted to start from scratch, so everything will be overhauled in this new title that they're working on, which leaves 2016 open, and we won't find any of this out until they just frankly tell us at E3, which is, I guarantee, when we'll hear something about it.
I'm excited for E3. I can't wait to hear the games they're going to pronounce this year. And even just the ones that are possible for next year. Are you throwing smoke or poison?
I threw a smoke to distract them while I was poisoning them.
Gotcha.
I think I did that on accident, actually.
I thought you threw poison, so, like, because they're still in a little group.
Oh wow, that's a lot of bodies in there right
Yeah.
there. Oh, and he's already
Yeah,
dead.
we're still on the outside. Like I said, it's going to take all our stealth to master this round.
Well, the berserk dart. There is definitely, oh, nope. Nope, can't do that.
I'm just shooting some berserk darts in that group, so that way, maybe, potentially, we get some distractors. Because my range on this, it's pretty significant. I mean,
you know,
now,
I got
not as significant as Jacob and Evie's throwing knife range, but...
All right, I'm in the haystack with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16.
Holy crap.
So well, if you want to throw a smoke down here or something, I can try and take them out.
I'll throw
a berserk right in this group, and then throw a smoke bomb, and I'll kill everybody.
Well, I'll be watching out for that berserk people for sure. I need to get a little closer. Hopefully I don't get spotted. Alright. There's berserk. Alright, I'll let the group build up real fast.
Yeah. Let it build up.
And I'll throw a smoke and you can get the hell out of there.
Go ahead with the smoke. I'm gonna try and kill everybody, see if that works.
Oh god, there's gonna be like 90. Watch out for me. I'll throw another smoke down.
Hurry.
There you go.
Man, those smoke bombs don't last for shit. I get out of there. Well, my reward is going down.
There you go. Oh, we might go get out that room in now. The window you just ran up upon.
Well, there are still people in there.
Oh, yeah, but not as much as there was.
Yeah, right. Stealth is really hard, which I like. All right,
I
like why it's super difficult.
Stack. I want to open that door down there.
Yeah, that's something I wish they'd bring back in Egypt, is the critical stealth. It actually, like, it makes you think of ways to get around. Because if there was one of those mission constraints, like there are in games, which I think they need to get rid of in the Assassin's Creed games, with those mission constraints. Because they always tell you, oh, it's an open world where we let you do whatever you want. But if you want the trophy and, like, the 100% sync, you got to do it our way. And that's not fun. I think those black box missions that they started doing with Unity, but they made better in Syndicate. You know what I'm talking about? The ones with the boss fights?
Mm-hmm.
Where you kill the main dudes. That's what they nailed right in Syndicate. I was very, the whole game of Syndicate, I liked it overall, but that's about as far as it goes. I just liked it. Not one of my favorite Assassin's Creeds. Everyone thinks it's great, which is awesome, but definitely not one of my favorites. But the one thing they did do right was the Templar assassination missions, because they gave you options to kill them and a special cinematic if you went a certain direction.
Watch out for that group of 5-4 right there. Alright, make sure you have your hidden blade, not your berserk darts. Or your fan blades.
Okay.
Just in case. Alright, I'll get this dude.
You got him? Okay. So, what are your...
Also...
Yeah, go ahead.
Go ahead.
No, you go ahead.
Oh, I was going to say, I love, like, when you're... The beauty in like these big mansions, like how much detail it is inside.
Oh yeah, definitely. That's something they can't take away.
I mean, just look at that. I mean, it looks like gold everywhere. Like,
do me a favor and throw a smoke bomb exactly where I'm at.
You mean throw it in the room?
Just right where my body is, a little bit lower.
There.
Right where the door is, door frame. Yeah, sure, there. Right there.
I threw it.
Well, nothing happened.
Okay.
Right there. Perfect. Oh, look, he's gone. Now what? What happened to our missing person?
Oh, God.
Throw another one, throw another one, throw another one, throw another one. Thank you.
I'm just watching Angle Vision right now, so...
Oh man.
Watch out. Got him.
Good. Good. So, what are your thoughts on possibly, since if we're not going to get an Assassin's Creed in 2016, because there was a rumor before this Egyptian stuff came out that. Assassin's Creed is going to make an Assassin's Creed collection. Ubisoft is going to make an Assassin's Creed collection because they just registered a domain name called Assassin's Creed Collection. So do you think we're going to see like a PS4 titles of like 1, 2, and 3?
I would love to see that. Honestly, I would honestly love to see that. Wake up.
Mm-hmm.
Because I really love the first set of games, and that would be amazing if they came back and like remastered them. Hang on, just don't do nothing yet. I saw a berserk instead of a hidden.
Oh. Oh snap. People are coming upstairs, man.
Okay, my dude will prepare to attack.
All right, I'll keep doing it.
Okay. Alright. See what this. Oh god, there's a whole crap. I wanna go do this with that.
You can. So, my take on. Here, come out through the door real quick. My take on 2016, I think we are gonna see an Assassin's Creed. I think we are going to see an Assassin's Creed in 2016. It's just going to be the collection where they're going to remaster 1, 2, and 3. The ones that didn't come out for PS4. And I think they're going to do it in November at just at a normal price.
Fake. Sorry.
Yeah, I'll be... If they do even do it at normal price and bring back that collection, I would probably still go out and buy it.
No, yeah, definitely. Definitely. You know, us being hardcore fans.
I would love to see it like remastered onto this console because seeing what the power they did and
Okay, I didn't know someone was watching me.
Alright. This mission has a failure.
Oh yeah, it was a failure.
Like, at first I was like, okay, we got this, and then realized there was no windows open.
Well, my reward's already gone down, but I mean, I can help you out.
I'm good. I mean, people did that. Oh, I just took one. Alright, never mind. Alright. So, to the roof.
The Assassin's Domain, the roof.
Amen to that.
Oh, why? Kind of scope out the area. Well, see, my plan was, since they were all facing the other direction, I could have straight up went in there and killed them all, but I didn't know there was someone behind me looking at me.
Right. All right. Well, that one in the middle, let's wait on, because. So, or you can go for it.
Nah, I'm not gonna go for it.
All right. Let me get in position. I'll be able to help you out from the rooftop. Okay, I should be able to help out.
About to get spotted anyway. So, what is your, out of all the games, what would be the one that you wanted to be remastered?
Of all the Assassin's Creed.
Yeah.
Probably the most I would like to remaster.
Huh.
Tough one. Because I'm honestly thinking between Assassin's Creed 2 and Assassin's Creed Brotherhood.
Okay.
Because I love Assassin's Creed 2 because, like, the open world generation, like, it just. Seeing how everything looked for on the PS3 console, I mean, it looked pretty freaking good.
And for sure.
Can you imagine, like, they came back and remastered that? But I also thought the same thing for Brotherhood, because Brotherhood is still pretty much one of my all-time favorites because of the virtual training. I'm gonna get this dude. So.
We ought to try a mission where we just do that. No kills? God, that'd be tough.
That would be very tough. If you want to go to the middle, it looks very clear.
Yeah, it is. Well, you know this one ain't it. It never is.
Never say never.
Never say never. Justin Bieber.
Your princess is in another castle.
I told you.
Alright.
You can't beat Mario in World 1. Alright, let's go over here. There's a window.
Alright, well, I'm still on the top. Okay. You're over there.
Yeah.
I just ran over here. So, maybe, just maybe. Okay. Come on, go back down.
I feel like if I kill. Yeah,
I thought you got him.
No, I told you I didn't.
You got him.
Oh, no, I didn't.
No.
We should have timed it.
I thought you went behind. I saw you sneak up behind him, so I was like, okay.
Yeah, I was going to, but the reason why I didn't was I didn't see you around.
Oh, I was on the other side.
Oh, shit. Never noticed him. And just walked right in like it was nobody's business. Like, oh, hey, how's it going? So, either between Assassin's Creed 2 and Assassin's Creed Brotherhood, my pick would be, for sure, can you guess it?
Assassin's Creed 2.
Of course. It's my favorite Assassin's Creed game.
Knowing you, yeah, you love the story. Like, you
the story is the best.
Nailed on.
Yeah, one of the best stories, in my opinion.
Okay, that works.
And that's how you do that.
Take care of that problem.
I'm nearly out of Phantom Blades.
The problem is the chest is on that floor below us.
Ah.
Alright, there's still two guards over here on this side.
Because I think Assassin's Creed 2 is actually. It has fair quality graphics. It's not the greatest for sure, I mean, Brotherhood made Assassin's Creed 2 look like crap, in my opinion.
Mm-hmm. Oh, hang on, I got poisoned.
Okay.
Somebody shoot it!
Like gunfire.
Don't come out this way.
What was that?
I'd be ready for anything.
Here, I got poison gas, I think, right? Yeah, I got two of them.
I did have two. Alright, there's a third one actually right back there, too.
Right, I was just behind you.
Probably want to go up a little bit more.
That should kill both of them. Hopefully.
On a good day.
Nice.
There it goes. There we go. Alright. There's a third dude way back there.
Yeah, he's coming.
He's gonna probably come in and investigate.
Oh shit. Well, you can get him now.
Hang on. If he comes this way, I'll get him. Which that is definitely the case.
Oh yeah. Guess what, motherfucker?
Gotcha!
You just got stabbed. Oh.
In the face.
Oh.
Alright.
Oh.
Okay, man. Calm down.
Yeah, I think Assassin's Creed 2 graphics were definitely not on par to what Assassin's Creed Brotherhood or Revelations had, for that matter. Good kill.
Mm-hmm.
Let's see what we got going on down here. Oh, coming upstairs.
Okay. Alright, let's think outside the box for this one. Were there stairs the way you came in?
He's coming.
Because we might be able to do like what we did earlier, except for time day, of course, to where we can both get out both at once. And so far, we got three people listening. That's awesome.
What the hell?
But yes.
Now enough of this.
Oh, come on. Get the fuck out of here.
Oh, God.
The house, bastard!
Bring him this way.
Search speed!
Nice.
All right.
Now, well, my reward is shit.
What?
My reward is like all the way at the bottom. It sucks ass.
Oh really?
Yeah, it's fucking
mine's still
depleted.
Mine's still about 19. Now, one of my questions for you is: will you think they'll ever bring back the two hidden blades, or they'll just stick to this one?
In Egypt?
Mm-hmm.
I don't even know if they will have hidden blades at all. Just because of the fact that if they go for the Egypt, I think that they should go for, which is even past
Altair,
and just like way back when. How would they even come up with something like that? Like a contraption, like the hidden blade?
Well, remember, the Egyptians, from what I remember in history class, they was pretty intelligent people. Like, they...
Yeah, because they had, like, signs from God and whatnot. You know, yada yada.
Yeah.
Alright, okay, one guy's coming. Oh, yeah, can't take cover. Here, I'll do this.
I don't know why you can't get cover. But
yeah, I don't know, that's weird.
One of the little fall glitches, unfortunately. I mean, they gotta give credit because the co-op in this game is just beautiful.
Yeah, it's bomb.
Totally stops talking because they know you're about to go in danger really quick.
He totally doesn't see my head peeking at him right now.
Oh. Where's he at? Alright, I can't get in there if I can spawn. Alright, okay. Oh god.
Here, I'll come out this way. Oh no, you got spotted too? Sweet!
Alright, that worked. Alright,
well. Oh, got a guy coming.
Yep, he spotted me. That's okay, I'm going for the chest.
Go for it. I'll go for him. I wonder if that's it.
Yeah, well, I would hope so, because we might have to check them on this map.
Oh, my reward is actually, like, straight up at the bottom.
We have a winner.
All right. I loved also the lock picking. Like, get him.
Suck my dick. All
right. Ooh. All right, so we need to find a way out. Alright, we need to find a way out. Oh, here we go. Find a way. Go this way. Da-da-da-da-da-da. Back to my favorite place, the rooftop. And then voila! Go across the road.
And we did it! Yeah! Alright, I got 5,000 and I got an extra 107.
I got an extra 7,000.
So. Extra 7,000?
Yeah.
Wow, man. I suck.
I remember you was the one training me on this game.
No, if I really focused, I'd do good.
Oh, yeah.
Tackle the thief! Get him. Alright, so I got a question for you, sir.
Yes.
Is the modern day story dead?
I don't think it's dead. I mean, of course, they haven't brought us any clues here lately, or in my opinion, they haven't. Any clues lately of the modern day story, because even though we all know Desmond is dead.
Yeah. But
like, as you see in Black Flag and a look, you as a character in a surgeon, right? Russo?
Who?
The character who plays Edward. You get to actually walk around and hack stuff, they say?
Yeah, in Assassin's Creed 4 is where you played as... You were in the first person of a Abstergo employee.
That one sounds smart and then realized that you're like a complete dumbass. Why would you ever say that? You call yourself an Assassin's Creed fan. Why?
But go ahead with what you were saying.
But even though they haven't seen, that's about as much content we've seen in the modern day world. I mean, here in Assassin's Creed Unity, we've realized we've seen this one woman in the whole thing. And then in Syndicate,
oh, Bishop.
We
yeah.
find out a little bit more in the modern day about Sean and Rebecca. Mm-hmm. And also another woman who, I guess, used to be an assassin. So maybe she was maybe playing that? Maybe, because she does have the skills.
Yeah, you're talking about the end of Syndicate.
The end of Syndicate, yes. And that end of.
You know, a lot of people gave Syndicate's ending a bad ending. I didn't see it, honestly. I didn't think it was that bad. I mean, yeah, they played some music while the modern day story was basically, you know. It was basically going on. But I don't think that's bad at all. What makes it bad? How many games have done that before?
Right. Well, at least it cannot say it was all a dream.
Yeah, I mean, honestly, that's Ubisoft's excuse for a lot of this game is, oh, if it glitches in the game, it was an Animus glitch. It was a glitch in the Animus. Those cheeky bastards. Ooh, I found a castle. Let's see where I'm at. One of the best things about this game is just going to a roof and figuring out like where you're at. Where's Notre Dame? Where's Notre Dame?
I think another great, I don't know what I'm saying. Just kind of, my mind just completely just blanked out for a second.
There it is.
Oh, that's right. I know what I was going to say. I love how this game, and I feel like this game was the first of all the Assassin's Creed to make it feel like when you climb a building, you're climbing a freaking building. Like, these ain't your normal like rooftops.
You're going to have to explain that, because I always felt like I was climbing a building.
Well, yeah, I do too. Alright, how I'm going to try to say is, it feels like these buildings are much taller, and how you got to climb them is a little bit more challenging than any other Assassin's Creed.
Well, that in part, I think that Assassin's Creed Unity nailed the parkour. Because I like how about just holding R2, for us PlayStation 4 users, holding R2 allows you to just move, like it's no problem. They did that in 4 and 3. But holding R2 and X while you're parkouring makes you jump farther, makes you jump higher. R2 and circle makes you parkour down. And they took that away in Syndicate, and you notice it, like, when you're on the top of a building, right? And you can't jump down to the side of another building because it's too low. It doesn't give you that option. You have to parkour down the side of the building. Even though you know if you were to jump, you'll lose some health, it doesn't give you that option. Which sucks. Because if I wanted to jump off this building right now, you know, Arno, kind of like, he gets near the side, he's like, whoa, I don't want to jump. But if I was to hit X, guess what? I'm jumping. I'm going to take a little bit of damage, but that's the quickest way down.
No witnesses.
All right, so I got another question for you.
Far away.
Alright, so you already know that I've always wanted Assassin's Creed to take place in Japan, feudal Japan. I always wanted to play as a ninja, and one of the parts why I love Black Flag, it's my second favorite Assassin's Creed game, is I get to play as a pirate. Not just an assassin, I get to play as a pirate. And I think beyond an Assassin's Creed game, Assassin's Creed 4 is the best pirate game out there. Like, if someone says, you know any good pirate games, you'll point them at Assassin's Creed 4. Not Pirates of the Caribbean or whatever pirate game that's out there. It's just super fun to play and has, in my opinion, one of the best soundtracks. So, not only were you having fun playing the game, like, remember the sea shanties?
Uh-huh.
Yeah. I thought that was so cool. Now, being in Japan, for me, I think that'd be super awesome. I can think of a billion things what I would do if I was to make that game. I could think of 10,000 things we could do right. But I think Ubisoft has made, like, some kind of, like, statement saying we're not going there. They're just not interested in it. Even though thousands of people have said, I want to play in feudal Japan, Ubisoft was basically like, nah. that's not our route. That's not where we're going to go. I think it's a lie. I think they are eventually going to go there. I just think if they do it, they want to nail it. They want to get it. They really want to get it right. So, back to my question to you. Where would you like Assassin's Creed to take place at?
That's like a kind of a, like, that's a good question, but to me, my favorites, I love a lot of people didn't like it, but I love the, I really like Assassin's Creed 3.
Yeah.
Because I love U.S. history, and like when I found out about like Assassin's 3 coming out for the American Revolution, I was really excited because I knew quite a bit about it, and I loved the whole Native American perspective. Kind of like how what you were saying about Black Flag, where if you want to play as a pirate, that's a game you would highly recommend. I like the Native American, and I love being out in the woods and actually being, wow, you almost got me there with the stack of wood. But if I had to ask a place to go to, I want to go back to somewhere that had that feature to the woods. I love the log climbing. I love the tree climbing.
So you like the dense forest of it, aspect of it.
And plus, I like how for Assassin's Creed 3, they had the first thing called as the rope dart, which I thought that was pretty freaking cool because you can hang people from a tree. Like, you just snatch them off one by one. Little do they know they're getting hanged.
Yeah,
I really like that feature. The stealth has may not have been all there in that game, but of course the combat was like Jacob, right, where he can just go through anything and everything and not take a single damage.
Mm-hmm.
So, in my opinion, I would like to go back somewhere deep forest. Three.
Okay, so give me a setting, like a place, or in a time period.
In a time period.
Yeah. Well, I mean, do you want to go back to America, like Civil War or something?
Yes, I would. Yeah. Now I'm going to think about it. I would like to see it, like maybe a Civil War, maybe something along those lines.
Yeah, I could
back
see
to America.
I would like
America,
that. Sure.
Because again, like that was America's like one of those greatest battles of all time.
It was the bloodiest battle. Most deaths in any American war, which is sad, obviously.
Yeah, it is sad because it only happened in our continent, but
it happened in our own country.
I mean, it is happening in our own country. When I say continent, I think great because it's a Saturday, so it's okay. My mind's
it's late
today.
On a Saturday.
Wait, did he just say continent?
Yeah, did he just fucking say continent? Civil War taking place in North America. Mexico gets involved. What the fuck? Oh, did not see that coming. Yeah, Mexico gets involved. Canada gets involved. But Europe is like, fuck it.
I would like to see the Civil War. About that time frame. And just because you know how they put Connor in that situation, kind of like at first he wanted to help out the rebels with George Washington, but at the same time, George Washington kind of turned his back and destroyed his tribe. So,
yeah, so he was kind of like
he was kind of like stuck in the middle, like, who should I really fight for?
Right, and so, in my opinion, one of the saddest characters in Assassin's Creed is Connor. Like, him being a minority, like, really, for the first time in Assassin's Creed, him being a minority, he's got so many, like, wars to fight, because he's fighting for George Washington, helping out the white folk, and then at the end of the game, you see, like, the enslavement of, you know, black people. Which is, right. You know, that's really sad. Because he knows there's nothing he can do about it. You know, he just won this war, and there's really no change. Besides tyranny and, like, democracy, he knows that there are still bad things that's going on in the world he's living in.
I do agree.
So, yeah, that's a...
And, of course, also,
American Civil War
3 kind of also gave the introduction to Black Flag for the little play of pirate mission.
Oh, yeah, the where you get to boat the ship and whatnot.
I know a lot of people liked it, but I was not a fan of it. I'll be completely honest. Black Flag, the whole pirate scheme, that it just didn't hit it off on me. I mean, I did like the fighting. I did like the other portions of it, but like taking off your hood and like being able like to walk like a normal person, other than like having your hood up all the time and like, you know. But just Black Flag just didn't hit it off for me for the pirate scheme. That's just me, my personal opinion. A lot of people are probably like, well, how they not hit you? You can do whatever the heck you want. You're a freaking pirate.
Mm-hmm.
So.
Yeah, and I respect your opinion, even though it sucks.
I mean, that's just my opinion. I mean, I know a lot of people don't like Assassin's Creed 3. I like Assassin's Creed 3, so just kind of suck it. I mean.
Yeah, just fucking suck my dick, you know? Assassin's Creed, I like it. Yeah,
every Assassin's Creed has its ups and downs. I mean, you can't fit everyone's expectations. I mean, hey, listen to you about the Japan. I mean, they're like, no.
They're like, no.
Not even like a, no, they're like, huh.
Oh, I just got in a big battle.
Oh, that's awesome. I'll try to do it as fast as you can. But that was another thing. As we was talking a little bit before, if you did really watch it, you see how I just came in and just assassinated, like, dude, literally moments before Blake got him. Like, I love that feature. I wish they'll bring it back.
Well, there you go.
So.
All right, you got another question for me?
Alright, in this new Assassin's Creed, do you think they're going to bring back, like, the Brotherhood? Like, how they had in Assassin's Creed Brotherhood, where you can get assassins off the street and train them up to become full-blown assassins? Or would they have something like in Syndicate, where you just get a gang, where people will fight for you, but it's not like a... where you can keep up... well, you upgrade them technically, but not like we used to in Brotherhood, where you actually gave them the full assassin's outfit.
I don't think there will be no... I don't think there will be a Brotherhood, honestly. Because if... I'm always thinking Egypt as in, you know, almost Jesus Christ era, like Roman Empire kind of era. So a Brotherhood wouldn't be established, I think. At my point, yeah, I don't think a Brotherhood would be established. And, You'll be a lone wolf. So if you're thinking like Assassin's Creed 2, where you can like buy prostitutes and thieves and whatnot, I could see him going with that. I could see you I don't know, like picking up slaves and being like hey, because I heard you get to play as a black guy playing as a slave. So maybe you can rally up
slaves.
There's a DLC slaves.
For Black Flag about being a slave. I think it was.
I didn't play that where you play as Ottawale.
I had a friend that played that, and he actually enjoyed it. I mean, it was like a little short DLC, kind of like about as big as Liberation. That's good Liberation.
Mm-hmm.
And he said it was really enjoyable. It's something, I mean, of course it did based off the lines of Black Flag, but it also had its own little story behind his opinion, or not his opinion, but the slave world, the slave life.
Bring your mic closer to your mouth if you can.
All right.
That sounds better.
All right. So.
All right, do I sound better too?
Oh yeah, you sound fine.
Oh man, don't have to get all sexy with me now. Oh man, you sound fine.
Hello.
Oh God, don't do that. Just kind of made me not want to talk to you.
Leaves like, well, as I thought, yeah,
well, that was a good podcast, episode one. All right, good episode one podcast, everybody. I won't be doing this again. My co-host is really weird.
My co-host won't be on the next one for sure. I hope they find another guy.
Yeah, the next one I'm getting Roger Craig Smith, the voice actor for Ezio.
Dude, can you imagine that? Like, actually being able to talk to him, like, while we play, like, Assassin's Creed?
Yeah, that'd be sweet.
Like, you'd just be like, alright, Ezio.
Because I know there was another podcast, another Assassin's Creed podcast called The Assassin's Den. I've seen that, and they were able to get a couple voice actors on their show. Even Roger Craig Smith. Now, I, for some ungodly reason, was able to get him on our never before seen podcast, where not a whole lot of people will watch this.
Off the crap myself.
Well, that, but I would make him do the entire show in his SEO voice.
I would be just like speechless.
That would be one of the mission constraints. Do like, the podcast in your voice.
Assassin's Creed. I would just be like too busy listening to his voice. Jesus, it sounds so
funny. Ooh, I see you.
Come in like an eagle.
And so, to really answer your question, no, I don't think the Brotherhood is even going to be established in this game. I think this is where I think they're going to try and start it all over. I think they're really going, because if the title is called Empire, I think that's what they're really going to try and do. They're going to try and build the Brotherhood from scratch, where they're going to try and get people to believe in the assassins. That's what I think.
I mean, maybe hopefully lead up to like Altair's age, to where it seems like a whole city of assassins.
But you know what? Now that I just now started thinking about this, here's a conversation piece. The Templar originated from the Knights Templar.
Mm-hmm.
And that originated in Assassin's Creed 1, where you actually fought Knights Templar. So maybe Rome will have to come into play, and maybe someone, I don't know, because they're talking about a follow-up, like where you're gonna play as the trilogy of the same dude, just like Ezio, and they're talking about maybe the second game will take place in Greece. But beyond that, talking about Greece and whatnot, I don't believe that one bit, just because it's too far in the future. Too far.
You kind of add on, kind of brought me up another question I'm thinking of when you just said trilogy.
Yeah.
You think this might restart a new trilogy, like with the same character, like how Ezio's trilogy was?
Or have
different, like, people involved in like a time period, like this game, for example. American trilogy, where they had Liberation, Assassin's Creed 3 and Assassin's Creed Black Flag, and then of course you got this game, Assassin's Creed Unity.
Well, that's not a trilogy. Even though they just found a way to package that, they called that the Americas trilogy, which is stupid. They just found a way to package it and call it and put it in a trilogy. That's Ezio was a trilogy because you were playing as the same character in three different settings. Well, technically more, because you played in Venice, Firenze? I know, I lost the name of it.
It's alright, even if I did see it, I probably wouldn't know pronounce it anyway, so. No, because I gotta do the country accent. Well, I guess I can't get my money.
Neither can I. Ezio Auditore da Firenze. I can't think of the fucking. Because I know it's not pronounced Firenze. Did I just kill a civilian? Well, fuck, I did.
No,
oh, well, it said I killed a civilian.
I killed one too.
Yeah, isn't that weird? Alright, so I got another question for you.
Alright.
Alright, you ready? You ready for this one?
Go ahead.
So, what game not made by Ubisoft reminds you most of an Assassin's Creed game?
Alright. So. Well, I would have to say that's not made by Ubisoft would probably be Uncharted.
Okay, you definitely gotta explain that to me.
Okay. I say Uncharted because looking at the both games, they both have like a really good scenery. They go in the most obnoxious places to do a simple mission. And the climbing and stealth is in those games.
Mm-hmm.
It kind of reminds me of it. But they also, how I also look at it, both games have like a goal in the end, like. In Assassin's Creed, you want to get to Apple Eden. Well, in Uncharted, you want to get the lost city of. I mean.
I get what you're saying. Like, the gold.
The gold, yes. So, that's the only game I've played that makes you feel. Not made by Ubisoft, that makes you feel like I'm playing Assassin's Creed.
That's interesting that you'd say that, honestly, because. Uncharted isn't even an open world game. It's a story focused action game. It's linear, really. So that's interesting you'd say that. I can't.
That's my opinion. I haven't played every single game in the world, but. I mean, in the games I have played, that's how I feel. Yeah. I was gonna say, we're just gonna let him get the kill, or just gonna leave.
No, we're not gonna let this guy walk away. Who do you think I am?
Arnold.
Ha! Retard. What if I came up behind you and slit your throat? You'd be like, what the fuck?
And you just saw me fall over like, oh my god.
Oh my god!
And you like hear me over the mic like...
just die. Oh my god. What powers do I possess?
Apparently not the power of rewinding time.
No. Who do I look like? Max Caulfield from Arcadia Bay?
Which, by the way, y'all should check out his channel for seeing that. That was one of the intense games ever seen.
Ever. In the history ever. Of the world.
In the history of video games.
Ever.
Because that was truly a... a game that if you want to keep like your anticipation up and you think you know what's going to happen in, but it changes. So I would highly recommend check it out, Blake Shirt's YouTube channel. Ow. I don't have nothing special besides this, so.
Alright, do you have any more questions for me? Because I got one more question for you, and it'll be my last question.
Well, throughout this whole broadcast, we've been answering my questions because, like, I had a question I was going to ask earlier, but we answered it. It said, I was going to ask, how far back in time do you think it'll go with this game?
Oh,
but
yeah.
Also, the answer. Now I kind of look at that question a little bit. I was like, how far back in time do you think the movie's going to go?
All right, well, I'm kind of glad you asked that because that rolls right into my question for you. What were you going to expect from the Assassin's Creed movie coming out in 2016? But I'll answer yours first because I think my answer will be shorter than my question to you. So how far do I think it'll go? How far back? Mm-hmm. Well, they've already released screenshots of Michael Fassbender in the Assassin's Creed outfit. Have you seen him?
No, I haven't.
Get on your phone and look it up. Type in Assassin's Creed Michael Fassbender.
Alright.
Yeah, he plays this character named Callum Lynch. They may have said when and where. I think it takes place in Rome. Or Italy or something. But yeah, in a couple of the pictures that you see of him.
Hang on, my internet's really laggy right now, so I'm still getting around Google Chrome, which I was sponsored by them.
Sponsored by Bud Light.
They would shut me down from everything. Alright. Yeah, I'll see you now.
Yeah, there's one of him, like, swinging a sword. Yeah, with his hood off. And, I mean, I see in this picture where with his hood off, he has a tattoo down the side of his eye, down his cheek. Looks like a couple people are being burned alive at the stake. It definitely looks like Knights Templar type era. And we got an executioner on the left side of the picture with one of those big black masks on. So, I don't know, 1400s maybe.
Alright.
I'd say a little bit before Ezio's time. I don't know. If they do it afterwards, then you know they're gonna make some type of mention of him.
Alright, now to answer your question about
what do you expect from the Assassin's Creed movie?
I bet you every Assassin's Creed fan's gotta say this. At least one scene of him jumping into a haystack from a good distance from a rooftop. And survive.
Oh yeah, you got to.
That's a better be in there scene. Huh? Because that's the one thing that I'm particularly about. And
so I mean, a lot of video game movies get a bad rap, Hitman movies. I know Naughty Dog, they're going to make a Last of Us movie. And with this Assassin's Creed movie, do you think it's going to kind of like break the curse? Do you think it's going to be good, is what I'm basically asking. Do you think it's going to be good, or do you think it's just going to be another mediocre movie?
I really can't say, because I really don't even know. Because I remember they make a movie of, like, Ezio's father.
They did, Assassin's Creed Lineage.
I mean, I've never seen it. I remember hearing about the amazing.
It's good. You should check it out. It's on YouTube. It's like a little over 30 minutes. It's really good just from that. And that was made, with like a lot of green screen stuff. You know, most game movies are. But I think you can expect a lot from the Assassin's Creed movie. I think they got a lot to answer for. Because I think nobody's expecting a whole lot from it. But it could be a sleeper hit. I think it'll be a game no one will talk about a whole lot. But I think it'll be good. Because Michael Fassbender's in it. He's the guy that plays Magneto in the X-Men movies. He's a stellar actor. So, my hopes are high, but not super high. And it's going to come out in December of this year, so we got a long time till then. It'll be after whatever Ubisoft decides to release this year. Like, The Division, and if that game comes out ever. We'll probably hear more about Wildlands. Yeah? About, like, if it's going to come out this year?
Yeah. They were like, what games are you excited for? I said I was excited for The Division, but they want to keep pushing it back, so I don't know how I feel about it anymore. But I am feeling about the Wild Runs, though. Wild Runs. I
mean, Wildlands.
Still got to wait for it, but when they released that pre-alpha, I got ecstatic. I saw it. I was like,
really, what's that game really called again?
Wildlands?
There you go.
Ghost Recon? Wow, I said Wild Runs.
Yeah, you're thinking of Need for Speed or something.
No, the crew.
Yeah, you are.
Game made by Ubisoft.
Yeah, I must have bought more games from Ubisoft.
It's what happens when you stay up all night and play games, and then you try to wake up 4 hours later. So.
So whoa, is that?
You all saw that. That was pretty cool. But yeah, but I can't wait. I can expect a lot of great things out of this year.
Oh yeah, there's gonna be a lot of stellar games. Fuck me!
I
jumped.
I ain't made a Ubisoft too. I mean, I just can't wait to see what else they have for us.
Uncharted 4. Can't wait for that.
Uncharted 4. Oh, we might even do a podcast about that.
Yeah, Uncharted 4 podcast episode 1.
We're playing Uncharted 3 on Psych! Oh, that would be a hilarious joke for YouTube.
Psych! Yeah, no. We just keep switching
it. Probably a picture of oh gosh. That's a long fall. That's a very long fall. Also, think about the movie. I expect some, like, air assassinations. If I can pronounce that right. Air assassination.
Air ass in nation? That's how you say it?
Air ass nation.
Air ass nation? Yeah, I expect that too, definitely.
No.
Yeah. No, definitely. I get what you're saying. You're definitely going to see all the tropes that you see in Assassin's Creed games. You are. It's just, you're going to see him jump into a hay bale. You're going to see him do an air assassination. You're going to see him kill Templars, obviously.
Oh, yes. We have to see that.
It's just the story. I think they're going to try and create a story that opens up the audience beyond Assassin's Creed fans, but they're going to try and get people into the universe. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
How the fuck do you get up this building?
You should try to figure a way to climb on top of this?
Yeah.
like
I was able to jump down and then come back up, and you're still trying to figure it out.
Oh. Well, I wasn't really focused on it for the longest time because, you know, I'm too busy laughing at my own, like, commentary of me, myself, and I trying to say certain words, like assassination.
Hey, the it's over here.
Oh, wow. Yeah. I'm not smart at all. I was just kind of following you for a little bit, and I was just like, okay.
I'll go my own way. He'll go his own way.
Ow!
Alright, so, I got a game for both of us to play. Alright, so, and this is a game you guys can play, if you're watching this, just go to BuzzFeed, Google BuzzFeed Assassin's Creed character, and, this is gonna see, what type of, character you are. So, Aaron, Chevy 93, I got a question for you.
Alright.
Which of these moments in time would you like to live in? Victorian England, the Italian Renaissance, the Golden Age of Piracy, the Ming Dynasty, the Wild West, or Paris?
What was the last one?
Paris.
Paris, okay. I said something else.
Nope, said Paris.
Huh.
Don't take too much time.
I know.
There's a lot of questions.
There's a lot of questions. Okay. I think the Wild West.
Okay. Wild West. So, the moment in time you like to live in is over Victorian England, Italian Renaissance, Golden Age of Piracy, the Wild West?
Yeah.
All right. All right. What do you desire? Do you desire equality, justice, respect, control, power, or booze?
I love the last one. I control respect.
That's what you desire is respect?
Yes, respect.
Okay.
Out of all the choices you gave me, respect would be the top one.
Alright, so you gotta choose a robe color. Alright, you got Assassin White, Florentine, that's the city, finally I figured it out, Florence, that was the city, Florentine Crimson, Sailor Blue, Deep Forest, Royal Purple, or Wetlands Auburn.
Assassin White.
Yeah, I'd probably do the same thing. Keep it simple.
White and black are my two favorite colors, so...
Well, that wasn't an option, in white and red. Here we go.
Well, I know.
What historical villain would you go back and assassinate? Would you assassinate Hitler, Vlad the Impaler, Jack the Ripper, Elizabeth Bathory, I'll just say Elizabeth, Attila the Hun, or... Caligula.
I'm stuck between Hitler and Jack the Reaper.
Jack the who?
Jack the Reaper.
The Reaper?
I want to say... Yeah, probably the Reaper.
Okay, the Reaper. You would like to assassinate Jack the Reaper?
Yes.
Alright, well... Good thing you'd kill nobody, because that person doesn't exist. It's Jack the Ripper.
Jack the Ripper. Wow. I am out of it.
Jack the Reaper.
I am. Jack the Reaper.
Hashtag LOL. All right. Jack the Ripper, then. How would you do it? Would you use a hidden blade, a sword, a rifle, an axe, a blunt weapon, or another assassin?
Hidden blade.
Okay, so you'd have to get up close and personal to kill this guy.
Yep.
All right. Plus, you never got to use one before.
Yep.
All right, what makes you angry? Stupidity in others or yourself? Feeling embarrassed, getting rejected, being manipulated, hypocrites, or injustice? Let's find out what kind of person you are.
Well, that's good. When you first said stupid people, I'm like, yeah, that makes you pretty pissed off. Yeah. So. Yeah, stupidity of people.
Stupidity in others, okay. Which quote about freedom inspires you the most?
Oh boy.
You don't have to be a man to fight for freedom. All you have to do is to be an intelligent human being. Malcolm X. We fight not to enslave, but to set a country free, and to make room upon the earth for honest men to live in. Thomas Paine. Those who deny freedom to others deserve it, not for themselves. Abraham Lincoln. He who is brave is free. Yeah, he who is brave is free. Seneca the Younger. Yet freedom, yet thy banner torn, but flying streams like the thunderstorm against the wind. George Gordon, Byron, 6th Baron Byron. Liberation is not deliverance. Victor Hugo. So out of all those ones I just said, and you've already probably forgot, which one was the one that connected you the most?
I think it's the second one. I think it's the second one, if I'm thinking correctly.
We fight not to enslave, but to set a country free and to make room upon the earth for honest men to live in.
Right, yeah.
Okay. I dig it. What's your pump-up song? Shots by LMFAO, I Will Survive by Gloria Gaynor, Fuck You, Lily Allen, Stronger by Kanye West, It's Time, Imagine Dragons, or Rock You Like a Hurricane, Scorpions.
All right. So, what was the original question?
It says, what's your pump-up song? Like, what gets you fucking pumped? Shots okay. by LMFAO, I Will Survive, Gloria Gaynor. Fuck You, Lily Allen. Never heard that song personally. Stronger by Kanye West. It's Time by Imagine Dragons. Or Rock You Like a Hurricane by the Scorpions.
I think it's time.
It's time to begin. Is it in? That one?
Yep, that's the one. Yep, that's what I was thinking. Because you said Imagine Dragons. I actually listened to it recently. So, because that new song, Friction, that's a good song.
All right, you ready for your result?
Oh boy.
And who do you think you're most like?
I would think, personally, I think I'm the most like is Connor.
Okay, this is your character.
Nobody.
I'll read the description of who you are, then I'll say the name.
Alright.
You've seen it all, haven't you? You're no pretender. You're no bandwagon jumper. You've been in the game from the very start, so nobody can question your credibility. You're not another in a long line. You're the first. You're the best. You are Altair Ibn Lahad.
Really?
Yep. You're the dude. You're the man. You started it all.
That's interesting.
All right, ready to do me?
Sure. All right, what was that website called?
I'm already on it, dude. I'll just do it myself.
You can do it then. You just say it out loud. And you can
which
say
of these
here.
Moments would you like to live in? I would like to... I would like to live in the Renaissance. I think that'd be cool. Bunch of loose women, drunken men, fancy clothes, loose women. And what do I desire? I desire respect also. Choose a robe color. I'm also gonna go assassin White. What historical villain would you go back and assassinate? Well, I wouldn't assassinate Jack the Reaper. I'd have to assassinate, you know, the man that murdered over 3 million Jews.
Yeah. See, I was stuck between him and the and Jack. So
how would I do it? I'd like to do it with a rifle. I'd like to snipe him.
I was gonna say blow his freaking face off.
Oh yeah. In that time period, there's no way you'd be able to get up close with him with a hidden blade. I would die.
Oh, yeah.
What makes me angry?
Stupid people.
Well, even though that does make me very, very... Oh, man, I really want to select that. But I think being manipulated...
I know you. You, like... Yeah, that would pretty much piss me off right off the bat. I mean...
I think being manipulated would piss me off even more. Even though I would never allow that to happen if it did. Oh shit, I gotta move,
Ow.
Ow, my back. Which quote inspires me the most? You don't have to be a man to fight for freedom. All you have to do is be an intelligent human being. We fight not to enslave, but to set a country free. And to make room upon the earth for honest men to live in. Those who deny freedom to others deserve it, not for themselves. I like that one. Because that's not freedom. The one by Abraham Lincoln. Those who deny freedom to others deserve it, not for themselves. Yeah, if I was to tell somebody, oh, you don't deserve that. You don't deserve that freedom. I shouldn't myself. What is my pump-up song? It's definitely Stronger by Kanye West. Okay. I'll read the description. You've got a chip on your shoulder. You strive to make the world better than it was. The tides of history are changing, and you know that things could get a lot worse. But that with a little effort, they could also get much, much better. I am Nikolai Orlov, the Russian assassin.
Really?
Yeah.
Which one's that?
He will be the character you play as in Assassin's Creed Chronicles once they take you to Russia. But he was also in the comics as well.
See, that's why I didn't know. I was like,
yeah, it's not just main characters. They're going like full on
every assassin ever known in mankind.
In the Assassin's Creed universe.
Oh yeah. What's up, piss pot?
You could be. Oh no. They wouldn't go that far. I would kill myself if they gave me the guy. I'd be like, oh, you're what the fuck is his name?
Ooh.
The guy that says piss pot all the time.
Hang on 1 second.
Are you going to your outfits too?
Yep.
Yeah, Bellick. His name is Bellick. I did the same thing.
Playing this game made me think of that.
Alright, let's do this!
But in all honesty, I thought your character, like when you first brought it up to me, saying which assassin would be most like you, I was honestly thinking, like somewhere between Ezio and Edward, like because I say that because I don't know, like an assassin between those two characters, because those two are two completely different characters in general. Whereas, see, I think that because you like doing the stealth, you are like the master of stealth when it comes to some missions.
Mm-hmm.
But when it's time to fight, you gather everyone and everything you possibly can, and you prepare for fight. Like, you don't let nothing stop you.
Okay.
So, how Edward kind of like that outgoing, like, all right, let's do this kind of person.
So you would associate me with Edward?
Yeah.
Okay, man, I appreciate that.
Yeah.
Oh, but you're telling me I'm a drunk though. That's what you're telling me.
No. I wasn't thinking of that portion.
Though. Oh, okay.
He does want to make a good time though.
Of course. I know how to have a good time. Palace. Before the
revolution, it was Paris's first museum. Oh, I remember
this. Oh, yeah. Transferred to the Louvre.
But some of it went missing. Complete dimension in less than 2 minutes.
Fudge, yeah, man. No, all right. So before we end this podcast, episode one, we're going to try and do this perfect still. So if we need to focus, we're going to have to buckle down for sure.
Oh, we're going to focus. Did you stock up on the merchant yet?
No, I didn't.
That's probably a good idea. Let's stock up on the merchant. More assassins, yeah. More loot. All right, where is this?
Actually, all the one are fake. You need to find I'll follow one. You. Go.
I mean, I got this thingy. Right.
Ammunition full.
Hey.
No, I need more phantom blades.
Yeah.
Yeah, definitely.
All right, here's one right here.
I'll follow you.
Yeah. All right.
Just make sure you don't get spotted by just random people.
Well, don't worry, it's outside the boundary.
No. It'll still count, bro.
Whoops.
Yeah, just attacking normal people from outside the boundary still counts.
All right, refill all. Sure. Alrighty.
Alright.
So.
Ooh. Kill the guy in the front. Kill the guy in the front.
Nice.
That was close.
I turned around. You just had your blade just in the dude's neck. Like, you were like, yeah.
Yeah. What?
Oh. Okay. I actually went back to on top of the rooftop to kind of like get this kind of look overview, and I see you over here on the actual main building. Like, whoop!
I got this. I swear. All
right. Okay. So, you think it's gonna be that close one again?
That'd be cool, wouldn't it?
Yeah, ain't the first time we did that. All right. Get back to my little spot right here. All right. Nope. Alright, come on. Call down. In the window. Alright, can't go that way. Good deal. Oh, Lord. You want me to take out the big dude? The big dude? My dog, you know.
Well, there's nothing in there for us to steal. Yeah, there's nothing in there for us to steal anyway, so. Let's not focus on them. There's one across the hall, so here's what we're gonna do.
Oh, I see him. Excuse me.
Go out the window you came in. Follow me.
Oh. Alright, so you took it out?
Yeah. Don't,
I looked over, I see this dude just like...
Did you kill him?
No.
Good. I'm gonna try and not kill anyone.
I go back. Alright, he's been finishing. Alright. Oh, I remember this. You and me, Trent. Sword. Okay.
Oh, yeah, I remember this.
Oh, God.
Are you up there? Dude, they're gonna spot you, bro.
All Alright, so how you want to counter this?
Well, one of them needs to get closer, because I can't... I can't get it, either of them.
Oh, right.
Got that guy.
Oh! I just saw him die, like, I ain't all right, see.
Get closer to him. All right, if you can assassinate the guy in the front, get him. Sorry, I had to.
Look above you.
Hey, how's it going, buddy? You were taking way too much time.
Like...
Oh, yeah, that thing I said about not killing anyone. Yeah, that's not going to happen.
That kind of blew out of water pretty quick.
Yeah, who the fuck do I look like? Do I look like Batman? No. I'm an assassin. This is Assassin's Creed world, not Batman world.
All right, so.
Okay. Oh shit! There's no open windows. Yeah.
Not on this side.
No, not that I see.
Oh, there's one right here.
You see one?
Yeah, I'm right next to it.
All right, wait there so I can come towards you.
All right, because there's a big dude looking this way. Or not looking this way, looking at that window, like, looking across the rooftop, like, looking like your position now.
Yeah, I know exactly what you're talking about.
Well, you see it now?
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
Lumberjack dude?
Yeah, I got him. I'm...
Yeah, I'm about to get him.
Yeah, because as of right now, there's no way I can get him without getting spotted.
Alright, well hang on, only for this other dude to go by first.
Man, he came over as if he spotted me.
Yeah, I wanna wait for him to go away, hopefully. It's pretty bad if he can't go away. Alright, good deal. Alright.
Alright, yeah, jump. There you go. Alright, get in there. There's another guy right there.
Look, it's Connor's tomahawk. Oh, it's not, never mind. Look at Connor's tomahawk.
His weapon?
Yeah, look, at an angle, it looked like Connor's tomahawk.
Okay, I guess I can see that. And I need you to kill this guy in the top hat. And wait for it. Did he see you?
No.
Alright, that's fine. Scoot back.
I does. Not
here. I can get him. As long as like you set him up in a good spot where I can get him.
Well, I didn't. He just looked at me and he said. Never mind. Wild geese and all.
Alright, he's a little wide. I don't know if I can grab him. Did you see that? I like jumped.
Yeah.
I like leaped off the wall.
Yeah, watch out. I seen a dude come out earlier.
We got a large group right here. Take cover. Find that door if you can.
I might make it to that door. Or that bookshelf thing.
Yeah, make sure you...
There he goes.
Are you inside?
Yeah, I'm inside right now.
Oh, on my screen, you're just, like, chilling on the outside.
Really?
I swear to God, like...
Well, I'm inside of it, so...
One guy's on his way out.
I know. If he comes around this corner, I'll get him. Too bad he can't whistle anymore.
Ah, shit, I can't get him.
Well, don't get him because...
What? What were you saying?
Well, there's four people right there just kind of like was watching them, but now they just kind of like all looked away. Like, I didn't see nothing. Nope, I didn't see nothing.
Well, I want to see if I can nail this guy, but
right.
I can't.
I want to try to get these two... want to take out that shooter because there's a window of opportunity to get us out here in a quick hurry.
Well, he won't move. He won't turn around. He's on lookout.
Well, I'm just saying, if we need to run out that window for anything. Oh, there's a window right there. There's three windows open over here, so I guess we don't have to worry about it. Don't waste a play on Blake.
Run!
Alright, get on the corner if you can, right here.
Alright.
That's so fucking weird. Alright, so I can't get the guy in the lumberjack, but I can get the smaller dude. Can you get the lumberjack? Sure. From where you're at?
Yes.
All right, be prepared. We're going to shoot. And 3, 2, 1. All right, good shot, good shot. All
right, let's see what those guys are going to do.
Ooh, what is it? I didn't know. Yeah.
Never mind.
All right, well, here's what we can do.
How did we used to do this before? Oh god, never mind. He turned around. No, I didn't.
Shit.
The window on that side when you try going? Oh,
well, I just killed the...
There's a lumberjack dude over the other side.
Alright, that's two people in a row I just killed, and this sniper is not doing jack shit about it.
There's a lumberjack on the other side, so if you throw a smoke, you might alert the lumberjack.
Well, I might need to just to kill him.
I might be able, I wonder if, maybe, hang on. I might be able to go down here and might be able to get him with the fan blade.
There's a lot of people down there.
No, okay. Just the balcony though.
Okay, well, let me scope it out, see.
All right. I can get him.
You can? All right, kill the lumberjack if you can. Make sure you won't get spotted.
Got him.
Well, this sniper is on point because he is not leaving his post.
He is. I am not moving.
All right, there we go. I just went for it.
Come pick her up. There's another sniper over there on that side.
Yeah, definitely always take out the sniper.
Oh shit, there's too many. Get that door. Hey, you made the door.
Hold on, let me get a sniper. Ooh, ooh, ooh. Move. What's happening? I don't know why I can't.
Damn it! Some bastards turned off Saint Pierre.
There's so many dead bodies.
Who's the guilty one then? Where are you?
Where are you? Huh? Where are you? Turn around.
He is literally right there. All right, here he comes.
Okay. Yeah, just wait right there. Chill. Had to time it perfectly. Right. I'm gonna work on this door.
Okay, alright.
Yeah, hope thank you.
Find him blow out there.
Alright, we got a lumberjack coming. We got a guy chilling over there. I can get behind cover over here.
Oh, good. Hey, I got one film,
dude.
I got to.
Better get back to the wow.
What?
Hold on, let me see if I can't lure him.
Oh, you have to lure, they get the little firecrackers.
Well, I don't want to lure.
Alert the other guy. Gotcha.
Yeah. Alright, he's coming. Or not. Whatever. I can't believe the Steelers just beat the
Did you?
What? That just what?
That dude was looking at my direction and you walked out there and killed that dude.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, straight up.
Where'd you go? Oh,
yeah. Yeah, I'm right here. Chilling, you know.
Oh, I didn't see you at first. I was like...
Yeah, I'm a snag him once he comes through this door. And then there's two more lumberjacks in that room.
Right, that's all that.
All right, let's move up.
Is it looking this way?
Get to the right side if you can. All right, good deal. All
right, how many people's in here? Two?
Three. How do you want to approach this?
Smoke bomb?
Yeah, smoke bomb and kill him.
Ready? Oh. Cancel.
Yeah, wait till they're all in the group.
Yeah.
Because now they're all separated.
Are you about to poison them?
No, that just wastes time.
Yeah.
Is the third person there?
Yeah.
And go.
Alright.
Is that it?
Your princess is in another castle.
Bah.
So. Babe, I did get a triple sync assassination though. That's pretty cool.
That's pretty sweet, yeah.
Alright, oh wait. What the heck? We got one right over here.
Yeah, there's one down here, but we gotta let's throw a berserk dart down here.
Dude.
What?
That's the right one.
What?
There was one right in front of me.
Are you serious? That's awesome. That's awesome. Perfect stealth. Alright, let's escape this area.
Pop fell.
Don't do that now.
Did you hear me? Like, my breath, though, was like...
Yeah, it was weird.
Like, I went out that window like full speed. So I was like, oh. Hang on, my dude wants to climb the top of the building before he realizes it's too high and needs to come down. he was already trying to think. He's like, shit, we got shit ton of guards down there, and somehow we got.
We probably could have killed everyone. Yeah, we probably could have killed everyone. Super stealth like. All right, guys. I guess that's all we have for this episode. Assassin's Creed podcast. Catch us every Saturday. No, I'm just kidding. We haven't created a time slot for how often we're going to do this. We might do this bi-weekly just because of news sake. There's not a whole lot of news that's covering Assassin's Creed, but if for some reason more news pops up and we have the time for it, we'll definitely get another episode up for you guys for those that are interested. For sure. So, do you have any closing words, Aaron?
Thanks for watching, folks.
All right. What's the... Yeah, no problem.
For Narnia!
I wanna... I said, for Narnia.
I want to find a leap of faith to end this with. So let's find a leap of faith.
Leap of faith first. My dude wants to stare at the wall. That's cool by me.
Yes, we have to end this epic with a leap of faith.
Hey, what's that over there, maybe? On top? You see that tall, kind of boxy thing right across the road? I'd be wondering.
I have no idea what you're talking about.
Take a right. Right building. Yep, that building right behind me. And there should be like a tall... Where those crates are being hanged off of. Maybe, hopefully. Not too close. Oh, that fell off. What? I'm wrong. Okay.
All right, let's hope and pray we get a good Assassin's Creed in 2017. I really hope they get an Assassin's Creed collection going on in 2016 for sure. Egypt seems like an awesome setting. We got a lot of high hopes for the Assassin's Creed movie. A lot of things we covered. But if you have any questions...
Booyah!
That you want to ask us, we'll definitely cover it in our next episode. Where'd you find a haystack?
Yep.
Ah, sweet. So, if you got anything for us, let us know in the comments, and we'll definitely put it in the next episode. But until then, guys, remember, nothing is true, and everything is
permitted.
Everything's permitted.